Thank you, Dave, and welcome everybody to the beautiful Petersen Events Center in Pittsburgh, one of the best on-campus facilities in the nation. The Panthers up to number 15 in the rankings this week, hosting the Providence College Friars, the only remaining winless team in Big East play so far this season. Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, Bill Raftery, delighted to have you with us. Certainly two teams that come into this one from opposite directions. Pittsburgh on back-to-back comeback wins, major comeback wins over Connecticut and Syracuse, and Providence 0-6 in the league with a team that's better than that.
Yeah, and Pittsburgh has really done a great job in their last couple of games, not only with the comebacks, but defensively they've been solid. They've really found a leader in Siobhan Trautman.
Well, you know, Siobhan's actually a very talented leader in terms of the way he competes. I think that's one thing, he sets the tone. But this Providence team, more time on the couch, Jay, I think, the last day or two, because they're right there. They just can't finish it.
Pittsburgh leads 5-2. Providence missed its first five shots before Ryan Gomes scored for the Friars. Now he bids to tie. And the rebound down to Chris Taft. This is Carl Krauser, their point guard. Taft. And this is Ronald Ramon, who's just in the game, as Antonio Graves, who started for Pittsburgh, has gone to the bench with two fouls, both on moving screens.
Tough matchup when you're thinking for Gomes. He's got to pay attention to Trautman, check him off the glass. Great offensive rebound there. Going to that right shoulder, Taft.
And he was fouled by Randall Hanke, the first on Hanke, as we check out Star Watch, two of the premier forwards, not only in the Big East, but in the country.
Well, Ryan Gomes, you're not going to find a more productive forward in the Big East, but he's got to be aggressive offensively in this game for Providence to have a chance on the road.
For a couple of years, we've been saying, take the Chevy to the levee. I mean, this guy can really load it up on the block, big, strong, tough, and he's moved his game out downtown about 15 feet.
One of these years, he'll make an all Big East team.
Isn't it amazing? He's easily forgotten by people, but he is a legitimate big-time performer.
But he was impossible to forget in the second half of that UConn game last Saturday. 25 points in the second half alone.
Well, Gomes has got to get inside. They got to establish him in there.
Tuukka Koti guarded by Levon Kendall. Donnie McGrath, who's playing on a tender right ankle that he turned Saturday against West Virginia.
Now, I think it's Trautman here. A nice load up by Gomes and the high low by Hanke.
Providence coached by Tim Welsh has had considerable success with the Friars, including last year when they were 20-9, finished third in the Big East. Jamie Dixon off to one of the great starts in the history of college basketball with that 45-8 record in two seasons. The Big East coach of the year last year in his first, taking over for Ben Howland, who assisted here for 4 years before Ben went to UCLA.
The youthful looking is Jamie Dixon.
He is 39 years old. Here's Krauser the other way. Good defense by Dwight Brewington to get back and alter the layup. Providence is 0-6 in the league, but those six losses by a combined 30 points, they've had a couple of real heartbreakers. They could easily have a much better record. Talking to Joey Hassett, one of their great stars and now a radio broadcaster on the Friars Network, he said, you know, it sounds ridiculous to say, but they could easily be 5-1 right now.
If they keep getting it inside that easily, they could start winning some games. That's where Gomes can do the damage.
And that's where he needs to be. If he starts out there, then he can be versatile and step away, but that's where he's devastating, is on the low block.
Big hands, don't get the turnover, but good dig.
And down to 10 to shoot for Pittsburgh. They're 2-for-4 from the floor. Krauser, a little shake and bake move. A back shot with the buzzer about to sound.
How about that crossover?
A poise, a little kiss at the end, tantalizing.
Gomes sets up inside. Nice baseline move. You talk, guys, about the need to get inside. They lost to West Virginia at home Saturday by 4, another one of those close games. Gomes at 4 points. And midway through the second half, Tim Welsh put him on the bench, told him you need to get underneath the basket. He went back in with 7 minutes to go, scored 19 points the rest of the way to finish with 23, very nearly pulled out the game.
See, if you don't give us more airtime, we're going to bench you too and see how you perform. Nice little low post, the ability to finish down low.
You know what Gomes reminds me of? He's kind of like the college version of Adrian Dantley or Mark Aguirre. You know, undersized, but he can really lock you down. He's got a variety of moves in the post. And just because people say, hey, Ryan, you've got to show, you've got a perimeter game as well, that doesn't mean he shouldn't go to his bread and butter all the time, which is that low block.
Mark McCarroll is in, as you saw, for Pittsburgh. Keith Benjamin has also come in. Chevy Trautman goes out. Charlie Birch has come in for Providence, number 33. And Deshaun White, number two, is also on the court, a freshman for the Friars.
A little bit of a match here. Saves Gomes a little bit. No foul problems.
That middle is wide open, but they can't see it.
5 second count, then the ball goes over to Providence. Tim Welsh and his staff thought that was about an 8 second count.
Timmy was saying to us today, they're going to use a lot of different looks defensively. You got to ring the bell on the other end, too, if you want to change the extent of the pressure.
Actually, it's a timeout. I thought Tony Green was signaling that the ball goes over to Providence. That's why Tim Welsh is right in his face now.
Well, he's asking for a walk. He says you've got to watch his feet, not just the ball, and not just looking for a timeout. He shuffled his feet all over the place.
I thought Tony Green signaled jump ball, too, with a 5 second.
No, he gave Krauser a timeout. He was in that double team forever.
I wonder if one of the other officials heard Jamie, possibly, or saw him.
No, well, Tony Green pointed toward the Pittsburgh bench, and apparently it was for timeout, not for the balls going in that direction. The officials are still trying to figure it out. Tim Higgins, Ed Corbett, and Tony Green with the basketball are the three officials. When they do resume play, Pittsburgh will have 4 seconds to shoot. Providence off that 20-win season last year, picked to finish sixth in the Big East in the middle of the pack this year in the preseason coaches poll. This is the third time they've ever started 0-6 in the conference. They've never gone 0-7. I don't blame Tim Welsh for being upset about this.
Oh, very tough call again. They got to really guard now, make it a tough catch and force them away from the hoop.
Now Ramon makes a three. That's the way it's been going this season for Providence.
Wow, what a swing that is. He knows how to play offense, Ronald Ramon. Solid, played a great game against Rutgers, showed his talent.
He was heavily recruited by Providence. As a matter of fact, Tim Welsh told us this morning, we thought Ramon was coming to Providence. Birch was stripped on the way up, and the Panthers are running. Benjamin called for the charge.
Here is what Tim Welsh was mad at a second ago. Watch when Krauser picks up his dribble. He shuffled his feet. He wound up 5 feet away from where he was before. If there's no foul, that is definitely a travel.
Tim Welsh singing the praises of his team when we visited him before the game tonight. He retained a positive, upbeat attitude despite the disappointments. Deshaun White gets it to roll in, the freshman from Philadelphia, who's averaging 6 points per game for PC.
Well, a lot of teams this year have shown that they can come back from adversity, even though they've had a few tough games in a row. Providence, one of those, to have six in a row that they arguably could have won. But it's not, if you win your next game, you've got a chance to put something together. And this is a place for them to start.
It's a big start for them. I think this is a must game for Providence at this stage in the season.
In all six of their league losses, they have been within 4 points with a minute 40 or less to go. They've had a chance to win every game, but yet they're 0-6.
There it is.
Nice play.
Underneath, and Aaron Gray, the 7-footer, was fouled and will go to the line after a media timeout. Early on in Pittsburgh, Carl Krauser and the Panthers with a 4-point lead.
All right, let's knock it out.
Yep.
Make sure you get that corner. Hey, ice cold Bud Lights at McKinney's.
We can finish this tomorrow, you know.
Yeah. Job well done.
Oh, yeah. Oh, now that's freaky.
Fresh, smooth, real Bud Light. It's all here.
At GMC, we know that payloads don't need to stretch their legs, listen to XM satellite radio, enjoy dual climate control, or watch DVDs. But people do. Introducing the new GMC Sierra 1500 Crew Cab. Professional-grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
Big breakfast burritos. Sonic's got them, others don't. Get a jump on your morning with Sonic's Big Breakfast Burrito. Fluffy eggs, sausage, and shredded cheese wrapped in a warm flour tortilla and served with a side of salsa. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
am seriously so much better at snowboarding than you are. It's unbelievable.
I'm a better carver, though. Have you seen my moves?
Look at this. Look at it. People say that I have really bad style, but I seriously don't.
Todd, no one says that.
Your mustache is hot, by the way.
Thank you.
Dependability and strength. The brokers of...
Hey, join the evolution. Okay, we're out.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here. And in part by Cadillac and the new STS with available performance-tuned all-wheel drive. Breakthrough.
Tonight's game from the spectacular Petersen Center, brought to you in beautiful ESPN2 HD. Presented by Phillips, Big Monday. Brought to you by Bud Light, Pittsburgh and Providence. And it's the Panthers with a four-point lead. They hammered the Friars last year at the Dunkin' Donuts Center in downtown Providence, winning 88-61 on March 2nd. And the big problem in that game for Providence was the matchup inside. This is a physical, tough, strong Pittsburgh team. And they can bring a lot of big bodies off the bench in addition to their starters, including this young man, Aaron Gray, at 7 feet, 275 pounds.
Lost 30 pounds, they said?
Down 32, 275.
I mean, he is really a powerful, imposing right now, Jay.
And he's finishing plays. That's really the difference. The better condition has helped. And having a very nice progression for a good big guy.
He was playing with the pros this summer. Did you see that note?
Mm-hmm.
Iverson, of course. Rasheed Wallace, 4-2 with his size. That'll get you ready.
59% free throw shooter. Ryan Gomes getting a breather for Providence for the moment. This is Deshaun White with Brewington, McGrath, Birch, and Herbert Hill, who was fouled by Gray.
And you mentioned White. He's really come around as a player. That was a great look by him.
A good read by Hill. A little flex look, and instead of coming up, he just cut right to the basket, and Gray got lost.
So Herbert Hill, a sophomore from Kinston, North Carolina, goes to the line. He's had a rough year from the stripe, 43%. So you knew he'd swish the first one.
Hey, yes, Villanova, 15-12-9, almost a triple-double against them.
He tied the Providence College record for block shots in the Big East game. Marcus Douthat at 9 against Connecticut back in 03. Cotee back in, and Birch grabs some pine. Get it?
I did. Thank you.
Glad I wasn't drinking anything.
They're going to get different looks. They're going to take advantage of the attack. Don't leave him.
Well, McGrath fell down, so Ramon was all alone. Donnie McGrath, as he's backpedaling back on defense, tripped at midcourt.
He's got that ankle, too, as he tees this one up, Sean.
And gets it to rattle in. He's had an up-and-down year, and kind of typical the way it's gone for Providence. Right when he was really starting to bury threes, he had made 8 out of 11 in two games. He turned his ankle against West Virginia after going 3-for-3 from three in the first 12 minutes. Gray the dunk.
Set up though. Krauser got it to the middle. He had Benjamin on one side. Great decision.
After a slow start for both teams, the offenses are heating up. Herbert Hill will have a chance for a three-point play. It's Big Monday presented by Bud Light from the sold-out Petersen Events Center. 3 years old, the Panthers 45-3 all-time in this building. Two of those losses have been this season. Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, and Bill Raftery. Pittsburgh 14-3 for the year. 5 out of 9 from the floor tonight. Hill missed the free throw. Providence started 0-for-6. They've made 5 of their last 6 from the floor. Krauser a deep three.
In the middle of that zone. Timmy wants the timeout. This is a deep team. They've developed the bench.
5 points for Krauser, who did not score in the first half Saturday against Syracuse, but was a big part of their comeback from the 17-point deficit.
Once we get this arrow off, we're in business here. The ability to stretch the D, the understanding of where to be, make two play one. You had mentioned earlier, Jay, they got it to the top on a high-low that time, and nobody matched up.
Well, Krauser made zero play one there. Nobody picked him up.
for Tuesday, presented by Toyota. And what a matchup at 7 Eastern tomorrow night. Big Ten rivals battling for conference leadership. Undefeated number one, Illinois at Michigan State. And then at 8 Eastern on ESPN2, Florida takes on Mississippi State. That's also available on ESPN2 HD. Call your cable operator, DirecTV of the Dish Network today. That might be the biggest obstacle left, fellas, for Illinois in terms of an undefeated regular season.
And they are saying in East Lansing right now, that is the hottest ticket in the history of that building.
Great atmosphere, too. The U-Zone. We've got, what's the zoo here?
Oakland Zoo back here.
Everybody's got something going. I think you're right, though. What a chance that Illinois is playing solid basketball, home and away.
2-3 zone for Pittsburgh. Gomes back in the game. Nice passing, and Herbert Hill. He's been effective off the bench. 6 points for Hill.
And once you make a goal, you can change the look. That timeout by Tim Wells was to really get into his team. They did not match up on the top. Now they go man.
Didn't communicate in that 2-3 zone. Nobody picked up the shooter, Carl Krauser.
He's a 43% three-point shooter. You can't let him just walk right up to the line and shoot it wide open.
Nice job by McGrath getting through that stagger.
Krauser, Ramon with the shot clock running out. Batted out by Gomes to McGrath. Providence looks to run with numbers. White had trouble on the catch. Out of bounds, last touch by Providence.
When Gomes can run the floor, the ball should have led him to the basket. They threw it between two offensive players.
When we talk about the last big obstacle, they do have some other road games left, but when you look at the remaining schedule for the undefeated top-ranked Illini, that does look to be the toughest game left on their schedule tomorrow night.
At Iowa is going to be a tough one as well. I think Iowa matches up with Illinois as well, if not better, than anybody left on their schedule.
And didn't they use the bench a little bit, took the starters out the other night at Iowa? They got a Pierre Pierce come in and started playing great basketball.
Boy, Pierre Pierce was magnificent at 25 points and really dominated Bracey Wright in that matchup. Mm-hmm.
This is dangerous, this tough and low.
Troutman. White, rather than playing defense, turned into official and gave the traveling signal after Troutman moved around him. He might have been right, though. Cotee out of the corner, long with a three. Gomes, the offensive rebound. And a rebound by Taft.
That was a big-time maneuver, though, offensively.
You're not going to see him miss many of those. Use that left hand. Nice pass.
They got messed up in the back. Cotee and Hill.
But how about the pass fake?
Yep. Set it up.
Pass fake really froze that defense.
6 points for Taft. He's the third leading scorer for the year at 13 and a half per game. Deshaun White stripped by Krauser, who has it back from Kendall. One-on-one now on McGrath. And it rolls in.
Okay, that's confidence. Nobody underneath. A little soft delivery. Tim Ross is not going to waste any timeouts. He knows how important this game is.
And how important to maintain contact early for the team that might be emotionally a little bit on the ropes.
Carl Krauser giving a little pass fake to Troutman. Really nice. Tuukka Koti not recovering fast enough.
And the good guards have developed this soft teardrop approach. Picks a lot of chin and falls through.
Does he remind you of Sherman Douglas?
A little bit body-wise. And of course, Sherman came up with some unbelievable three-second lane deliveries.
7-2 run over the last 2.5 minutes for Pittsburgh. That's the game we talked about. They fell behind 22-5 early, but they knew they could come back from 17 down. In their previous game at Connecticut, they trailed by 17. Came back to beat the UConn Huskies by 10 in stores. They beat Syracuse by 7 here Saturday night.
Krauser's done a really nice job over the past couple of games, especially in the second halves, of running the team. I think if you had one criticism of Krauser, he tends to over dribble a bit. When he makes passes and runs the offense, this is a tough team to beat.
Gomes, another three, and Taft the rebound. That's what you guys are talking about. You know, possession, they could really use a score. They don't need Gomes out of the three-point line.
Well, that's what next time down, Kendall with a big-time rebound. Well, that's what happens when you play with Troutman. But next time he's got to get inside, Sean. Gomes, that is.
And Birch called for the foul for Providence. His first, and a timeout.
If a lunar rover can get out of a ditch on the moon, if a tugboat can tow an enormous freighter
If an M1 tank can have a heavy-duty Allison transmission, then why can't your truck? At GMC, our engineers don't just ask questions, they have answers. The GMC Sierra line of pickups. Professional-grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
And then don't touch.
They're all rookie cards.
Hey, guys, got us a treat. Chicken enchiladas. Smothered in melty, saucy, cheesy.
Smothered.
On the inside.
Oh.
The chicken enchilada grilled stuffed burrito from Taco Bell. Slow simmered savory enchilada sauce, tender all white meat chicken and melted cheese. Wrapped up, then grilled to go.
So what's that for?
For enchilada taste that's delicious inside and out, think outside the bun.
Remember when it was $600 million tax dollars to build a football stadium? A surprise, the cost is rising. A platform will add $55 million. A game porch, $66 million. A pedestrian tunnel, $30 million. And oh, the stadium gets $400 million in taxpayer-subsidized bonds. Taxpayer cost? Hundreds of millions more. And climbing fast. Say no to a Westside stadium.
A moment like this, some people wait a lifetime. For a moment like this, some people search forever for that one special kiss. Oh, I can't believe it's happening to me. Some people wait a lifetime for a moment like this.
Create unforgettable moments at Sandals All-Inclusive Resorts. Call 1-800-SANDALS.
It's Big Monday tonight on ESPN2, but as always presented by Bud Light. Number 15, Pittsburgh, a 5-point lead over Providence. They've taken advantage of some defensive lapses from the Friars and benefited from some nifty play by Carl Krauser.
Carl Krauser has really led the way. He's played with great change of pace, change of direction. He has found open people. And when the defense runs away from him, he finds a way to knock it down, Bill Raftery.
Well, you know, you're complimenting the offense. And the defense was atrocious.
On those last two.
You felt they weren't communicating. Maybe not sure Cote may have been in man when they, in fact, were in his zone.
Pittsburgh with the ball. Just under 8 minutes to go in the first half. Antonio Graves back in for Pittsburgh. The sophomore picked up two quick fouls. Troutman fouled.
And then Birch with the reach in. You mentioned Krauser playing well. I think the depth of the team has made him play better. There are guys to support him, play alongside him, and urge him on, too. A little bit of a challenge.
Seventh team foul against Providence, so it's the bonus, and a 1-1 for Troutman. 70% from the free throw line. That was a rock that was pulled down by Randall Hanke.
Is in. I think he's got a touch at the majority of the time. Give him a couple of opportunities.
Burlington running the point now with McGrath on the bench. They've had troubles in past games when McGrath's been out with turnovers. Gomes scores. They turned it over. Nice call, Bill. 27 times against West Virginia the other night with McGrath injured most of the game. In the game against Villanova, in which McGrath did not play at all, they had 30 turnovers in a narrow defeat.
We mentioned the word flex all the time. This is what got Gomes in. They were patient. He down screens and then locks his guy across the lane. I mean, that's just solid basketball. I can't understand. These guys got to give him an opportunity once or twice a trip to touch it.
He should get the opportunity to touch it, but part of it's on him, Bill. He's got to go down into the post and demand the ball and make guys guard him.
And it's not for lack of the coaches harping on that. As we said, Tim Welsh put him on the bench Saturday to drive home that point. Graves got the first free throw. Sophomore from Mansfield, Ohio, averaging 7 points per game.
You almost get the feeling Gomes is too nice a kid. It's like not willing to really get after beg and demand.
Well, he is painfully unselfish, which is fine, but I think it's all right. I think it's more unselfish of him to go down into the post because he draws so much defensive attention. He either scores or gets fouled, which his teammates like, and then he can kick it out to open people when he draws that much attention.
McGrath back in the game now for Providence, down by five, nearing 7 minutes left in the half. Gomes, the preseason conference Big East player of the year, first Providence player ever with that honor, missed with the left, but then got a hand on it to get it back for Birch.
Nice look.
Brewington, bad pass, mentioned the turnover problems. That was a terrible pass. Krauser. The floater.
Nice job by Taft with the discard.
He ran the floor early, set up shop, and contributed with the offensive rebound.
Well, that's where he can be really effective, is on the offensive glass, because he can keep the ball alive.
McGrath for three out of the corner.
What a difference in him when he plays with confidence. Ever since the Boston College game, he's really shot the ball confidently.
Yeah, he got a little hold here, a little small change. Brewington. Timmy thinks he's really had a solid run of late defensively as well.
Yep. His defense much improved this year. Two fouls on Brewington. That's a concern. He averages 14 a game. Jeff Parmer is in. He's played sparingly this year, 9 games all season. And he scored 2 points this season, the entire year, against the University of Maine. Ramon gets the first free throw, the freshman from the Bronx.
All Hallows. John Kerry was his coach for a few years. Now he's up at Fairfield. His dad was a great player, is it right? The Dominican Republic and Brazil and Argentina. Mm-hmm.
Ricardo Ramon, who is his son's idol, said everything I learned about basketball was from my dad.
Well, they have a connection with the Dominican Republic. Ricardo Greer, of course, Orlando Antiqua, one of the assistants here.
Gomes trying to turn the corner with the left, just a little bit short, and Taft the rebound. 6 minutes to go in the half. Hit by six and running. Ooh. Kendall got away with a walk.
He sure did.
And didn't get away with that elbow to Parmer. We mentioned the Dominican connections, the connection to the New York City Gauchos, AAU team. They've had a number of players over the years who have played for that squad, and Barry Rorson. He's the man in New York City with the great recruiting connections.
A friend of mine asked him, you know, do you just recruit New York? He said, I recruit all over. He said, but, you know, like a pitcher, you go with your best pitch. And he knows that city and Catholic League better than most.
Just a terrific coach, recruiter, and all the other responsibilities that come with being a coach.
They really look like they're designing more for Gomes, and you're right. He'll give it up. He won't force it.
He's working on the baseline. Taft comes over to swat it. And give Kendall credit. Gomes has beaten him a couple of times tonight, but Kendall is making him work hard for everything.
He's got that long arm, sticks it out on him.
Ramon was fouled.
Well, the good work that Kendall does there allows Taft the time to come over from the weak side and knock that ball away. And that's where Taft is especially effective, is as a weak side shot blocker rather than just on the ball.
Ray Cross, another guy deep down the bench, committed that foul for Providence, sending Ramon back to the line. Tim Wilson, we really thought Ramon was going to come to Providence. His dad's very friendly with Manny Ramirez and Pedro Martinez. And the young man enjoyed his visit to Providence very much, but he wound up going to Pittsburgh.
Really got a nice feel for the game. Fundamentally sound. Makes good decisions out on the floor. And I think he could come in and do a pretty darn good job at the point guard position if Krauser's ever out.
Well, he can really handle the ball as well. He can take his guy and be creative. This is how they got Gomes down on the box earlier. Of course, he's not in there at this point. They get a hold.
Are you surprised that Cross and Parmer are both in the game for Providence?
I think Timmy's decided he's going to give everybody an opportunity. This is how important the game is, the situation. Give some fresh blood. And also, to match Pitt, we were talking off air, Jay thinks they're methodical. They just keep punishing you physically. I think it wears people down.
Here's Parmer, as we mentioned, just 2 points all year against Maine, and wow. That missed everything to the right.
Look at this carve-out area by Chevy, and then the bounce pass to coordinate his vision.
Just locks you down. He plays angles so well.
Not too bad, huh, Hill? Just catch, turnaround jumper.
And just as easy on the other end of the floor. Hill just jumping in front of Taft. Taft standing straight up defensively.
And yeah, not a good foul here again by Farmer.
Troutman just runs the floor and immediately gets his body right into Hill and is able to keep that angle.
You just can't get around him. Physically imposing, and there's a toughness about him.
Farmer the foul, so Ramon with the double bonus in effect now will shoot two. That was the 10th team foul.
One of the things about Siobhan Troutman, he is unafraid of sticking his nose in the pile. I mean, he's really a tough customer.
Tomorrow night, ESPN and ESPN2 have college basketball action. First at 7 Eastern on ESPN. Illinois undefeated takes on Michigan State. At 8 Eastern here on ESPN2, Florida's long-distance sharp shooting Anthony Roberson leads the Gators against Mississippi State. Super Tuesday presented by Toyota.
I can't wait for that Michigan State-Illinois game. There are going to be a lot of juniors and seniors on the floor. Paul Davis coming back from that sprained ankle. And he's going to be vital for the chances of Michigan State to knock off number one at the present.
Well, they got experience in the perimeter, too, to compete with Illinois.
Sean White, the bucket. 4 minutes to go. Pittsburgh by 8 here in the first half. Krauser with Ramon, Kendall, Troutman, and Gray for the Pittsburgh Panthers. McGrath's back in. Brewington is in with two fouls. The reason Cross was in, trying to save Brewington for the foul difficulty. Traveling the call as Gray took a stroll.
And Gomes helped close the walk.
3.5 to go. First half, it's Big Monday, presented by Bud Light on ESPN2.
Bassett presents the John Elway Home Collection. Home entertainment furniture, custom built to match your idea of the perfect TV room. Choose the fabrics, finishes, and features that suit your decor. And complete the look with one of Sony's best-selling televisions. The full line of John Elway Home Entertainment Furniture is on sale now. We make it easy to afford with flexible financing plans to fit any budget. Visit or enter online and you can win a complete Elway Home Theater. The new John Elway Home Collection, exclusively at Bassett.
When you've been recognized by J.D. Power & Associates as the most dependable heavy-duty full-size pickup truck, there's no need to be bashful. GMC Sierra, professional grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
Introducing an SUV so powerful it can take you someplace you've never been before. The Volvo XC90 V8. Find out more, watch the big game, or visit boldlygo.com.
Presenting the new Infiniti G35, available with intelligent all-wheel drive that automatically changes when conditions change. The new G35 from Infiniti.
Introducing an SUV so powerful it can take you someplace you've never been before. The Volvo XC90 V8. Find out more, watch the big game, or visit boldlygo.com.
Reese Davis, Digger Phelps, and Mike Jarvis coming up on the Century 21 Halftime Report. Kansas answered a challenge, and we'll have the big man on campus from the past week. Mike, what do you think of what you've seen in the first half so far?
Well, first of all, there's no answers right now for Krauser, and Providence has got to find a way to contain him.
I also think Providence has got to get Rath's favorite player back and go get some points from the brewmaster. Brewington's got to score, Rath.
We'll see you at halftime, guys.
Raftery knows something about the brewmaster. Yeah. He has a different take on that than.
You know, that's an ethnic slur.
Yes.
By Digger.
Well, it's always tough on the visitor here. Providence has come to a tough place to try to get their first league win of the season. 45-3 in this beautiful new building, led by that raucous student section. They won their first 34 games here. Syracuse finally won as the visiting team last season. Then the Stunners. Early in this year, a lot of people said, uh-oh, Pittsburgh is not as good as everybody thought they were going to be. They lost to Bucknell and Georgetown back-to-back here. Well, Bucknell's pretty good.
Bucknell's pretty good, and we know Georgetown's done. John Thompson, the third, has done a nice kick out. This is the unselfish play of Combs. Give it to him. Let him make some decisions.
And McGrath continues red hot from beyond the arc. It was 8 for 11 in the two games prior to tonight from beyond the arc, and 3 for 4 tonight. Gray gets the soft foul. Boy, that rim has been friendly to the Panthers here in the first half.
Well, they ran two screens to get Troutman to the box. I mean, once he gets it, you're in trouble. Everybody, the heads turn.
Brewington following Digger Phelps' instructions. Gomes, the offensive rebound, and fouled by Gray.
Well, as Digger said, get it to Brewington, but I think I'll go inside the Gomes to make the decision right in here. He'll give it to the right people at the right time. He won't force the issue. The real understanding, you can actually step in and cheat a little more if you're McGrath and get an easier look by that line.
But they need to run the offense through Ryan Gomes. When he gets the ball and draws that many defenders, you're going to have a wide open shot out.
Tim Welsh made the point this morning. That replay was an example of it. Gomes, when he gets double triple teamed like that, his solution on his own is to drift further and further away from the basket, thinking they won't double team me way out here. Well, Tim Welsh would rather have them double and triple team him to leave somebody like McGrath open.
And Timmy's giving him tapes to look and bring home and discuss
your tapes. Following, he was watching your suggestions on a previous television.
Well, I thought Timmy was smarter than that.
Ramon has had a good first half, guarded by Brewington. Kendall with Cote on him. Nearing 2 minutes left in the half, Pittsburgh by five.
They run some nice things to get the big guys to the box. Just like a little pick.
Out to the miss. Taft is too big for Brewington, and Hill not very active inside.
But intelligently keeping it alive until he can grab it.
10 for Taft, the rookie of the year of the Big East last year. First team preseason all Big East this year.
Now McGrath's telling Gomes to get in there, and that's the right move. Now Krauser with the little nickel dimer.
And that's the double bonus.
When you are active, you get opportunities. And the active Chris Taft, one of the better offensive rebounders in the Big East, keeping that ball alive. And the more he keeps it alive, the more he has a chance to corral it. And when he does, the easy score, as productive as he's been in a first half all this season.
And where was Hill going? And he starts running up the court.
Well, he thought they had it, which is a mistake.
Leaving Brewington to battle Taft. 10 points now for McGrath, the junior from Katona, New York.
Talking to Barry Worsen about Taft and also and Coach Antigua, the focus is what they've been after for him to concentrate more. So his work habits are good, but be more consistent.
People expect him to really blow up this year, but he's having a normal progression for a really good college player.
Providence scrambling on defense, and Krauser makes the three.
It was all the way cross court. That's great hustle by McGrath, but why is Krauser that free? Somebody's got to help him.
10 for Krauser. And an air ball by Gomes, who looks winded.
Well, this happened earlier at the top of the key. Little scramble defense. You can't leave him free like that.
Minute to go in the half. Pittsburgh by eight.
Great
by 10. Taft to Troutman.
They give him a bump to get him to the box, and then a great pass by the center.
Well, he just went like he was going to set a staggered screen and just slipped it and got to the low box. The design play. Little misdirection.
I like Gomes going right back inside here.
Trautman goes like he's going to set a screen, slips at the other end. Look at Krauser setting that screen, just sort of backing up against the defender and allows Trautman to get the angle and an easy basket. Got to put more pressure on the ball.
Subtle screens, though. Krauser with the derriere.
Foul on Kendall is his second. I mentioned Gomes looked tired with the air ball for the three. He looked tired trying to defend that last play we showed. And he's a good free throw shooter, but wasn't close with that one. Much improved free throw shooter over his career. Went from 61% as a freshman to 87, one of the best in the country last year. He's drifted back to 74% this season.
Well, Jamie Dixon does a nice job with Trautman. He doesn't load up on the box. He screens, then gets a screen. So it makes the defender run the floor more than he's accustomed to, particularly a post defender.
Well, one of the best ways to get open is to set a screen first.
Where they're trying to trap Ramon. He's short. They get the steal, but then Gomes came down on the end line.
Got to go over the top, Death Valley, in any of those corners.
Now Ed Corbett wants to speak with Tony Green. We might have a question about the shot clock, but it's off because there's only 32 and a half seconds left in the half.
That's got to be a foul, you're right. Under normal circumstances.
Benjamin trying to play it in with Gomes right in his face, and a kick.
He was in a great place to be trapped, too.
That's a tough angle to come in. Look at this angle of the pass. It goes, they didn't touch anybody, I don't think.
No. That should be Providence's ball. I don't think it hit anybody. Yes, it is, says Tony Green. And Brewington's going to come in for Cross, who was there pressing Krauser. If it touched anybody, it was Krauser.
Well, it had to hit somebody. They're giving him out of bounds on the opposite side.
Right, it should
maybe
be the far
maybe
corner.
They're saying the pass hit the baseline right where they took it in.
Could very well be.
Brewington still has not scored. Out of bounds, Providence ball, says the outside official, Ed Corbett.
I would play for one here.
Yep, that's what Tim Welsh is saying.
Ooh.
Almost not enough on that pass out to McGrath.
Krauser didn't see it.
Krauser looked to the bench, see if they want him to move up on McGrath.
See, I like them running their offense down so that when they're starting, they get right into it.
Let it go with about 4, maybe 3 seconds on the clock. So you have time for an offensive rebound, but not enough time for Pitt to go the other way.
McGrath, they need a shot. Gomes for three, short. Boy, he looked like he was out of gas at the end of this half.
He tried to hustle the shot.
10 points for Krauser and Pittsburgh with a 9-point lead at the break. It's 43-34. Let's go back to the studio now for the Century 21 halftime report.
Thank you. The Friars struggles continuing. Pittsburgh with the lead at the break. Before we get to plenty of hoops, a couple of other news items to tell you about. Terrell Owens practiced with the Eagles in Super Bowl practice today. Of course, doctors have yet to clear him. Philadelphia saying that will be up to T.O., Andy Reid, and the team doctors. His teammates said that Owens looked good. He participated in roughly 10 plays, about a third of the Eagles' offensive plays during practice, and they said he looked very smooth. Sammy Sosa, the deal to the Orioles has been approved by the Major League Players Association because more than $1 million is changing hands. Commissioner Bud Selig also had to give the okay for this deal. In exchange to get all of this done, Sosa is going to sign an addendum to his contract that would void some guaranteed options for the future. Still to come on the Century 21 Halftime Report. Bitter border rivals, Kansas and Missouri, they get together, but the Jayhawks able to answer a challenge, and we'll also give you the big man on campus. Would it be a guy from Wazoo?
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Saab. Welcome to the State of Independence and USA Today. Never gray.
If a lunar rover can get out of a ditch on the moon, if a tugboat can tow an enormous freighter, if an M1 tank can have a heavy-duty Allison transmission, then why can't your truck?
At GMC, our engineers don't just ask questions, they have answers. The GMC Sierra line of pickups. Professional-grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
You're curious to learn more about me. I'm a complicated man. On the one hand, I order off McDonald's dollar menu. Get the double cheeseburger and lots more. Very affordable. On the other hand, my friends have nicknamed me Helmet Head because I once got a helmet stuck on my head.
61.
I see you're intrigued.
In an instant, this detective's life changed forever.
Jim Dunbar, I'm assigned here.
What are you going to be able to do at a crime scene?
Same thing I've been doing for the last 10 years.
But you won't be able to see anything.
Do you smell that?
I don't smell anything.
Someone fired a gun in here.
This March.
Don't sell us on how you're going to be holding your own around here.
One man will struggle.
There isn't a cop who doesn't respect you, but no one wants to go out on the street with you.
To get back what he lost.
I don't want to be held back.
All I want is a chance.
Blind Justice premieres Tuesday, March 8th, only on ABC. Welcome back to the Century 21 Halftime Report.
Carl Krauser, 10 points, 3 assists. Pittsburgh, they've been on a roll of late, and they are up by 9 on Providence, who has not been on a roll yet to win a game in the Big East so far this season. Glad to have you with us on the Century 21 Halftime Report. Digger Phelps and Mike Jarvis joining me. Earlier tonight over on ESPN, Kansas and Missouri, these two, of course, bitter rivals. Mizzou's been struggling, only a 500 ball club. And Kansas, with a little bit of a short turnaround after an emotional game against Texas on Saturday night. And the Tigers got off to a good start, actually, by finishing the first half strong. A 20-4 run as Jason Conley knocks it down. Mizzou had an 8-point lead at the break. But in the second half, Wayne Simeon getting it done inside, Mike.
Well, did a great job. And, of course, not only scoring, but also just giving great leadership to his team.
And Aaron Miles at his best. One of his 10 assists 19 times in his career. He's had 10 or more assists in a game.
I mentioned that 20-4 run Missouri had at the end of the half. Kansas had a 16-4 run that put it away. The walk-on, Christian Moody. He's not your average walk-on. And Mr. Miles dishing it out again. You see J.R. Giddens. Well, shot fake, put it on the floor. Jayhawks pull away from Quinn Snyder's team. 73-61. Simeon finishing with 22-9.
Uncharacteristic. Bill Self goes to a 1-2-2 zone with 10 left. They jump back into lead 54-51. It was lights out after that. They could not make the threes. 1-for-9, Mizzou the rest of the game.
For Kansas rolls on, still unbeaten in Big 12 play. Last time they started this well, they ran the table in the Big 12. That was the 01-02 season when they finished 16-0. New Mexico has a lead on San Diego State. Danny Granger back in the lineup. The Lobos 15-2 with Granger, 0-3 without him. And Air Force has a 23-game home court winning streak. They are second in the nation behind Oklahoma State's 27-game home court winning streak. Don't forget, we've got more Big Monday coming your way, presented by Bud Light. We will go to the Mountain West. Andrew Bogut, this guy might be the best big man in the country, leads Utah against BYU.
A lot of NBA scouts think he may be the number one pick in the draft.
He probably will be.
Be able to see Andrew Bogut live in a living color, midnight Eastern time. That's 9 out on the West Coast. Bracket Buster Saturday is set. This is a highlight event on ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPN Full Court to give some of the mid-majors that might need another quality win to boost those RPI and resume numbers. You'll be able to see it February 19th. A lot of great games among them. Western Michigan going to Northern Iowa. Western Michigan hovering around 40 or so in the RPI standings. I think Wisconsin-Milwaukee gets the best deal of all. They get to go to Hawaii.
I like Hawaii, but how about the first game? UTEP at Pacific. I like the top of that. Why? UTEP played in the NCAA tournament, lost to Maryland last year, and Pacific got to the second round. After they beat Providence, they lost to Kansas. So you've got NCAA tournaments in this bracket buster this year.
Well, you do. I'll tell you, there's another game. The Drexel Dragons. Philadelphia is on a roll. And Bruiser Flint has got his team, I think, ready to go back to the big dance.
And I still get nightmares about that team called Arkansas Little Rock.
You just tried to beat me to the punch because you knew I would bring up the Trojans.
Thanks.
You know how Arkansas Little Rock can bust a bracket because they took care of your Notre Dame team.
Took care of us. And then Jimmy V had a beat on NC State in the second round in Minneapolis many years back. But I'll tell you, these teams that you don't realize, anytime you look at, I think, the mid-majors this season, they're going to be in the hunt for two bids in a lot of conferences. And this is why the bracket buster is so important. You see these key matches. matchups.
Bracket Buster Saturday, February 19th on the Family of Networks. You won't want to miss it. As is our custom on Mondays, we deliver the big man on campus, several candidates to choose from. One guy from the Palouse who went down to the desert and shot some lights out. Is Thomas Kalidi the guy, or perhaps the Cardinal is more to your liking? We'll see in a bit.
This halftime report is brought to you by Century 21. Visit your local Century 21 office. Real estate for your world.
So, how about this one?
We did say no ranches, right?
Yeah.
Well,
plenty more where that came from.
This next one is more of a colonial-inspired ranch.
It's still a ranch.
Not working with a Century 21 agent? Pledge point number 13. Century 21 agents only show you houses you want to see.
This one's more of a Tudor-inspired ranch.
No, it's not.
Just one of the ways to help reduce the stress of buying real estate. Century 21, real estate for your world.
When you've been recognized by J.D. Power & Associates as the most dependable heavy-duty full-size pickup truck, there's no need to be bashful. GMC Sierra, professional grade engineering. It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
If a relaxing moment turns into the right moment, will you be ready? You can be with Cialis. Cialis is the only erectile dysfunction tablet clinically proven to both work fast and work up to 36 hours. 36 hours to relax and take your time. 36 hours to choose the moment that's right for you and your partner. Cialis is only for men healthy enough for sexual activity. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain or certain alpha blockers for prostate problems or high blood pressure, as this may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Don't drink alcohol in excess with Cialis. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. Erections lasting longer than 4 hours, though rare, require immediate medical help. Discuss your health status with your doctor and ask if Cialis is right for you. 36-hour Cialis. When the moment is right, will you be ready?
I like to make food that makes people happy.
Denny's new meat lover scramble comes with bacon, sausage, and ham mixed right in with the eggs. And the Heartland scramble. Then I add bacon, sausage, hash browns, and pancakes. And they're just $4.99. Denny's, we're cooking now.
You know, you have a great story. But the 86 Mets, now that's Cinderella's story.
ESPN's coming to the Walt Disney World Resort. Join us in Florida for ESPN The Weekend. Go to ESPNTheWeekend.com now.
This is the Century 21 Halftime Report.
Pittsburgh and Providence at the break. Panthers have a 9-point lead. It's become a staple of Big Monday, the big man on campus. And there were certainly plenty of candidates from the week that was, including one hot shooting Cardinal, Larry O'Bannon of Louisville against Marquette, was just outstanding, Mike.
Well, we start with Larry O for offense O'Bannon, who is usually the third or fourth option on this Louisville team. However, against Marquette, he goes for 30, a career high. He goes 6-for-6 from three-point line. And he continues to do all of the other things to help his team win.
How about Washington State, Thomas Kalidi, 7 big threes against Arizona. Arizona knocks off Washington on Thursday, but they lose at home to Washington State. Why? 27 points on 7 threes. Big win for Washington State. And Dick Bennett on the road got it done. How about Stanford, another Pac-10 team? Matt Harris, he combines for 20 points and 20 rebounds. Was tough in the paint, got it done inside on the boards, and even dove on a loose ball for a save all over the floor. Big win for Stanford in third place in the Pac-10.
The 2020 vision of Matt Harris and the Cardinals. Digger, you're very strong on the Pac-10 this big Monday, but there were also buzzer beaters.
With 5 left, this is Finn. Burrell, there's your 3. Got it! He bottomed out that tray with 3 tenths left.
Doyle quickly, corner, Jenkins, 3.
Yes! Bring it up! And Northwestern wins!
Well, Of the shooters touching the home roll for Michael Jenkins, these are the candidates: O'Bannon, Burrell, Harris, Jenkins, and Kaladi. You can log on to ESPN.com. There is still some time to vote, and we will give the answer a little bit later on a Big Monday and let you know who you think the big man on campus is for this week. Carl Krauser hoping to get off to a good start, a little Earl Monroe-esque move there. Panthers by nine.
This halftime report is brought to you by Century 21. Visit your local Century 21 office. Real estate for your world.
On Tuesday, celebrate the man behind the legend.
The innovator of soul, the genius himself, Ray Charles.
Let his music move you.
What you say?
Let his life inspire you.
I hear like you see, like that hummingbird outside the window. A heart just gives a beat.
Nominated for 6 Academy Awards, Best Picture, Best Director, and Best Actor, Jamie Foxx. Ray, own the DVD Tuesday.
Boomerangs remind me of Australia.
They remind me of my heartburn. It keeps coming back 2-3 days a week. So I carry these.
Hey, that's frequent heartburn. Maybe you should try a different kind of medicine.
Like?
Prilosec OTC.
It's the only OTC that directly shuts down lots of acid pumps. That's why one pill a day can work for 24 hours.
24 hours of zero heartburn.
Bye-bye, Boomerang.
One pill a day.
24 hours.
Zero heartburn.
Isn't it time for a more productive meeting? Microsoft Office Live Meeting. The service that gives you the power to meet with 2 to thousands from virtually anywhere. See for yourself with a free trial. You can present to clients around the globe, train employees in multiple locations, even launch a new product. All with just a PC, a phone, and an internet connection. It's web conferencing at its best, from the company determined to make it even better.
Playboy TV On Demand gives you instant access to a variety of Playboy TV movies and shows that you can fast forward and rewind again. Subscribe to Playboy TV Monthly Service, and you can get Playboy TV On Demand for only $4.95 more per month. A library of the very best of Playboy TV at the push of a button. Playboy TV, up for anything. Available on IO Digital Cable Service from Cablevision. Call 1-866-59-DIGITAL.
It's always the same dream. I'm standing on top of my building, and it starts to grow. It starts slow, then it gets faster. Clouds fly past me, and suddenly it's all a blur. The air gets colder and thinner, and I can't catch my breath. Mergers, acquisitions, network integration, one guy to sort it all out. Growth is supposed to be a good thing, right?
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Nissan. Everything we touch, we shift. And everything we shift, we try to make better.
Pittsburgh by 9 at halftime here at the Petersen Events Center. The Panthers with the lead on the strength of 58% shooting from the field. Well, Providence shot 44%. A lot of the damage done by Pittsburgh inside. That created the advantage from the free throw line. Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, Bill Raftery, welcome back to Pittsburgh. And when you play Pittsburgh, you know job one is dealing with that powerful inside game. Providence is so-so at best in that regard.
Yeah, they've not done a great job of keeping Chevy Troutman and Chris Taft away from the basket. And the same goes for Carl Krauser. Too easy with that entry pass into the post. And then on the break, Krauser getting way too deep, drawing the defense. Troutman able to lock down. Chris Taft was really strong, I thought, on the offensive glass as well, Bill.
I think Krauser really ran the show well, bit them with some shots. But I think Gomes, they know what they have to do. Get him some touches inside and then step into a shooting area if they happen to double him. They need a big half. This is maybe the most important game of the season, I think, for Providence.
Boy, but Sean's point in the first half, well taken, that Gomes got a little worn out. I thought he was a little tired toward the end of that first half. He has to carry an awfully big load out there.
Well, he's got to run after Troutman. I mean, plus, physically, he's so imposing. He weakens you as the game progresses.
And this is a warm building. I mean, we all three noticed that during the first half. It's warm in here. Gomes and McGrath had 11 points each, but Gomes had 12 shots, went 4 for 12 from the floor, 0 for 4 from 3.
McGrath is 3-for-4 from three. Brewington did not score. They could really use some help from Brewington, who had averaged 18 points per game over the previous four, and he averages 14 per game for the year. McGrath, Brewington, Hill, Cote, and Gomes for Coach Tim Welsh to open the second half.
Now, one of the problems that Brewington has in a game like this is Pittsburgh is so physical, and he is slight of build, gets knocked around a little bit.
As Krauser on him in the corner. Taft up on Hill.
Nice play.
Gomes been going regularly to that left over Troutman, and it would not fall. Here's Krauser with Graves, Kendall, Troutman, and Taft to open the second half for Coach Jamie Dixon.
And they're trying to match up. You'll notice Krauser at the top. McGrath made sure to tag him.
And a kick by Brewington will reset the shot clock, he said.
You mentioned Krauser before with Sherman Douglas. A boxer when he was younger, 2-0. Retired very young, obviously. But there's a toughness about him.
You get a belt when you're 2-0.
Now you got him thinking about a belt.
Anytime we're past halftime, Raptor's thinking about a belt. Krauser for three. Jab here in the second half.
Buckle up.
Well, he's had an awful lot of time on his three-point shots to get his feet set and square.
Brewington. Hill, who gave him some good work at the offensive end with 8 points. He rolls to the bucket and scores.
Nice pass by Gomes. You know, Ben Howland established a toughness defensively, and Jamie Dixon has carried it on. I'm thinking of Krauser with Brewington. This is a challenge. He wants to shut him out.
And he does it in a physical way. He's able to bump him off his path, bump him further away from the basket than his moves are longer, his passes are longer.
Graves a miss, and Tuukka Koti the rebound. He also did not score in the first half, and he averages 10 per game. In traffic, Troutman, as is so often the case, comes away with it.
He's got glue.
He is strong. They list him at 240, but he told us he's just a shade under 260. We talked to this morning. Taft, wild miss from very close.
Probably should have jammed that one, but he probably was too far under.
Yeah, just not knowing where he is. Tried to hold his man off, did a pretty good job of it, but found himself too far under.
Nice help.
Last touched by Pittsburgh. That time it was Troutman guarding and Kendall helping.
Jam it up and help out. That's part of the philosophy. Kendall maybe not as strong as Troutman, but alert on that particular play.
And Kendall getting it with his left hand. How about the block he had against UConn?
That's a foul on Krauser.
That was your college day performance, right? The all-dayer up in Husky territory.
Krauser the skip pass. That's an awful lot of time to get your feet set, square up. I mean, you don't get that much time in a game of horse.
He's 3-for-3 from three. The foul on Krauser, his second. Ramon back in now for the Panthers, who lead by 10, 2.5 into the second half.
Solid job by Trotman. Look how far out Gomes has to go to get it.
That's okay. You had mentioned that in the first half, too. He can do that, but at least he's got an area to forward. He can manufacture some points.
13 for Gomes. He averages 19.
Trotman looking for that little dump down flash to the high post.
They will just X the big guys up and down. He and Taft.
Troutman in the lane forever. And finally, the 3-second call by Tim Higgins.
Ryan Gomes with the ability to get himself free, knowing he's going to get the basketball. Nice breakdown here, triple threat position. And Troutman with the power to get him away from the box. I think that's pretty important.
Yeah, just the inside pivot, a little look down to freeze the defender, and up with the shot.
He's got him locked again. Good help by Taft.
Brewington, McGrath is open. Missed a three. And Cote first touched that rebound, but Kraft ripped it away from him. Troutman, former Mr. Basketball in Pennsylvania, and a foul on the dump down to Taft. Fouls on Gomes, his first.
One of the few times in this game you've seen Taft really get into the defender and seal him off. That was a really solid job offensively.
Sean White comes in for Tuukka Koti.
You know, playing with Trautman, you really learn how to get free in that lane area. Here he is again. That is amazing.
You need to take one dribble and jam it.
Don't you think a lot of this is just Pittsburgh wants a little more when they go after these loose balls? Yeah. And they're a little stronger going to the loose balls?
I think part of it's their patience, too. They know they're going to get it to the big guys. They're going to get an opportunity, so they'll reverse the ball and don't make a lot of mistakes.
I mean, the last time they were down at this end, Koti had an offensive rebound. Taft ripped it away. That time, Providence had better position on their defensive end. The Friars did not wind up with the ball. Brewington way off tonight, and Taft the rebound.
Well, it's so physical that now Providence is settling for jump shots. It's easier, it's available, and they are settling.
And the zone has given them ample opportunities here, too. Look at this kick out and an open look.
And Taft, I thought he got away with the push off, but Tim Higgins, slightly tardy with the whistle, got the call. Crowd didn't like it, but it was the right call. First foul on Taft. Coming up, we'll look back at Jerome Lane's amazing delivery.
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship coming in March.
Every great story starts with a great adventure. Introducing the all-new Nissan Pathfinder, the 270-horsepower engine, three-row seating for seven, refined interior with GPS navigation and DVD entertainment, and more off-road capability than ever before. Because you can't talk about the mountaintop unless you actually see the mountaintop. Tell better stories in the new 7-passenger, 270-horsepower Nissan Pathfinder.
This is a Big Mac. It has 30 grams of fat. Now, I know what you're thinking. Yeah, but it's big, right? Well, this is even bigger. A 6-inch sweet onion chicken teriyaki sub from Subway restaurants, and it has 6 grams of fat. I know where I'm going. Subway. Eat fresh.
I can create the stage for our lives. I can go plush, be polished, and still stay on budget.
You can. At the Home Depot, we offer more new flooring innovations and fashions every season, and we're driving down the cost every day. Like now, Pergo Presto Laminate is 20% off. Find expert installation you can trust, and trust that if you ever find a lower price, we'll beat it by 10% guaranteed.
At the Home Depot, you can do it, we can help.
When it comes to shipping, talk is cheap, mistakes aren't.
Brown's got the horsepower. They've got the planes, the technology. Truth is, I don't care how they do it. I just care that my packages get there on time. Hey, all I ask for is perfection. Other than that, I'm pretty easy.
UPS delivers more packages on time than anyone. UPS, what can Brown do for you?
This is a Big Mac. It has 30 grams of fat. Now, I know what you're thinking. Yeah, but it's big, right? Well, this is even bigger. A 6-inch sweet onion chicken teriyaki sub from Subway restaurants, and it has 6 grams of fat. I know where I'm going. Subway. Eat fresh.
Picked off by Miller. Goes ahead. Lane's on the other wing. He finds
it. Oh! Oh! Sent it in, Jerome!
Be a while.
Well, a memorable delivery by Jerome Lane of Pittsburgh against Providence, and a memorable call of that play by Mike Gorman.
I went to college to be able to have that call.
Back then, what was it like working with a great play-by-play guy?
Well, also, hey, whose side are you on?
Also, the background is New England as well.
Mike Gorman.
He has style.
He does.
And grace.
Truly one of the really outstanding play-by-play men in the country. But that was voted one of the most memorable moments of the 25 years of ESPN college basketball. We celebrated that last year.
And not just by your family.
It's pretty disappointing there weren't better moments than that. a thrill for us.
The old Fitzgerald Fieldhouse, where Pittsburgh is tough, but they're even tougher in this building.
Nice hands, Benjamin.
They have some guards.
And they just make you work for everything. Great team defense for Pittsburgh.
Look at this picking apart, Sean. And the strength to hold on. Take the hit.
Siobhan Troutman fouled by Hill, and a chance for the old-fashioned three-point play.
Right now, they're just picking them apart, slide into position, just an extraordinary look, but solid from the pick by Benjamin to the other end of the floor.
And they just methodically move it out on you. This is not a team that delivers a knockout blow, just body blow after body blow, and they wear you out.
Some nights they're maybe not pretty, but effective.
Effective indeed. And Troutman particularly effective in leading both of those comebacks against Connecticut and Syracuse. That win against Connecticut, he had a career-high 29 up in stores.
Watch out when Providence makes a cut. They can't finish their cut. They're just getting bumped off their path.
McGrath to Gomes, and he's raked.
You know, they take it personal, the guy they're guarding. They want to stop him, and then they assist once he gives the basketball up.
Fouls on Keith Benjamin, the freshman, his second. There's a young man who really stepped forward Saturday against Syracuse. Gomes looking for his 14th point. Benjamin, the highly touted freshman out of Mount Vernon, New York, the same high school that produced Ben Gordon, Gus and Ray Williams, Scooter and Rodney McRae, very highly touted newcomer, but bothered by a lot of injuries, meniscus problems with the knee, ankle problems, had played in very limited action all season long, a total of 58 minutes all year before he played a career-high 21 minutes against Syracuse Saturday, of 10 points to spark their rally. Gomes fouled by Gray.
And McGrath with a nice look. Interesting, he was the first verbal Benjamin to Jamie Dixon as the head coach. First verbal commitment. 44% three-point shooter in high school, so you know he can fill it up. But as you mentioned, they could never get him going with all the difficulties due to injuries.
They even talked about redshirting. Deshaun White missed the first one.
And coming in from high school last year, Jamie Dixon thought that Benjamin would come along a lot quicker than Ronald Rameau.
I love their rotation now. The young guys are getting a lot of confidence.
Were you like me? You know, I thought when they scuffled a little bit against Bucknell and Georgetown, and maybe their pick third in the Big East was too high behind Syracuse and Connecticut, that maybe people didn't factor in the loss of Julius Page and Jerron Brown enough, but they're back legit, and I think another Sweet 16 contending team here at Pittsburgh for the fourth year in a row if they get there.
Well, they're adjusting to new roles, and that takes time, but these kids are stepping up into new opportunities and learning how to play a little bit of a different way.
And Brown, you mentioned defense with Pittsburgh. Page and Brown just lock people up. That's tough to replace immediately.
31-5 last year, their third straight Big East regular season title, with identical records all three seasons of 13-3 in the league. Benjamin for three. That's a big sequence there. McGrath had a three that rattled out, came down, and bounced on the rim some more and didn't drop. And at the other end, Benjamin drills a three.
Boy, Troutman, right?
And it's just too easy. You get it into Troutman into the middle. He looks down to Gray. That freezes the defense and then looks across.
White turned it over to Krauser for the breakaway layup.
He's got a little Sammy Sosa thing working there. Did he kiss his hand before he laid that in?
15 for Krauser. And a 13-point lead for the homestanding Pitt Panthers.
Tonight on SportsCenter, a big Monday border showdown in Kansas and what a two-time Super Bowl MVP can't do. Plus details on T.O.'s practice run in Jacksonville. SportsCenter after the X Games.
Bruce.
Hey, Kev.
Wow, that was fast. I can't believe this is it. What are you going to do in the offseason?
Oh, probably just, you know, delivering pizzas.
Pizza's here.
you all the time. You think you're a little bit much, waiting to give me a line. Give me a line. Give me a love. Give me a taste. Yeah, that's right. You're gonna have to chase me.
Only Red Lobster makes jumbo shrimp the way you crave it. Big, tender, sweet, crunchy, decadent. Choose your favorite right now at Red Lobster.
Hey!
Where you been?
Well, we needed a break from the city, so we hop in our new Nissan Pathfinder. We drive to a small town and hear, hey, you got Kel's Holmes hit? So we go even farther and find a dude ranch, see horses, see cowboys, see a guy saying the best pizzas at Lombardi's. We head off-road to go hiking in New Mexico. New Yorkers, mud baths at the hot springs. Hey, I'm in your building! We drive farther and farther down a canyon, across a river to the most peaceful, secluded, far away from the city place, and we realize we missed you guys.
Hey!
The new 7-passenger, 270-horsepower Nissan Pathfinder.
Pittsburgh with the lead, and the steal by Krauser taking it the other way, and dare I say, the kiss.
Ooh, the sweet little smooch.
Now, he's got a little hot dog in him.
Yes, he does.
You know, fortunately, Providence did not see the kiss, so it's not rubbing it in.
Well, you play this well, this solid. They were worried about their three-point shooting early in the year, too. Now they're more selective.
And they don't make a ton of threes, but they're the best shooting team in the league. 42% from three for the year.
Well, they take good ones, and there's some value in that.
And look at them all around. Gomes gets a look, but a lot of hands sniping.
Providence in danger, losing contact now. This 13-point deficit, their largest, and Troutman with a chance to make it 16.
You know, he runs the court so well and gets that deep low post position, and there is nothing you can do about it. He reminds me a little bit of a bigger and stronger, but a poor man's Rick Fox, doesn't he?
Wow, that's a good example. He doesn't have Rick's outside game, I would say, but the body, and Hill was frustrated. You could see it in his face there. Just got locked low by one of the masters.
Watch how deep he gets on this bend. Goes all the way into a catcher's crouch before he shoots it.
He's one of the terrific offensive rebounds, and on a missed free throw, he's extraordinary as well. Slaps it back to his teammates.
10 for Troutman. He averages 14 and a half per game. Randall Hankey has come in. Nice. He'll try to mix it up. Low Brewington just can't buy a basket to dig deep into the cliche barrel. Gray the rebound. Ramon Troutman too strong on the follow, and Brewington way up for the rebound.
He is relentless, Troutman. Look at him sprint back. Now he just grabs him, making sure that wasn't his guy, but he's not going to let anybody score if he can help it.
Well, that was a break for Pittsburgh. They got called for a foul when it was going to be an easy lay-in for Hankey had there not been a whistle. Second foul on Siobhan Troutman.
He's a new kid, I think. I mean, you see him blossom. He was quiet when he first came here, Troutman. And now he's got the leadership qualities and smiles.
Gomes got Troutman in the air. And drew a foul. And that's two quick fouls in a row, and three in all now on Troutman.
Almost a clinic in staying low on the post, not allowing Troutman to break contact and get around in front. That's what the great post players do. They keep contact and move you around with their backside.
But a little thing, he forced the offensive player to Taft, too. You know, he should have backed off when he knew Taft was there, but he was real smart. Didn't let him go baseline. He had help in the middle.
Better numbers tonight for Gomes, but the field goal percentage down, as is usually the case when you play these Panthers and make you work so hard for everything. Troutman on the bench with three fouls. And Mark McCarroll back in. He's been injury plagued all season long, and his numbers are down, averaging just 2.5 points per game and 13 minutes per game.
And he can shoot it outside. He really stretches the D, makes it an easier entry pass.
Krauser. And it gets tipped out to Brewington. And a three wouldn't go for Birch.
Gomes is on the bench right now. Interesting, you would think with Troutman out of the game, that might be the time to let Gomes stay in there and take advantage of Troutman being on the bench.
The thought process is good, but I think he was tired, a little rest for a minute or two before the TV timeout, and I think that's what they'll do, Sean. Bring him back.
Yep, just get him those extra seconds before the media timeout. That's why Tim Welsh is coaching, and we're over here.
The Hyundai Sonata was named highest-ranked entry midsize car in initial quality by J.D. Power & Associates. So how do we make it even better? First, you add a $750 special value package at no additional cost. Then you offer $1,500 cash back. And don't forget, every Sonata is backed by America's best warranty, 10 years, 100,000 miles. The Hyundai Sonata GLS special value model is now available at your Hyundai dealer. Starting at $17,499. Don't miss your opportunity to get the special value package and $1,500 cash back.
What the needs now
lovely.
Is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs.
Everyone wants it. Basketball's got it. ESPN College Game Day, Saturdays at 11.
Fueled by Mountain Dew.
Dell Service and Support, can I help you?
You're there.
Yes, sir, we're here 24-7, 365.
What about leap year?
366.
Rest easy with award-winning service and support behind every Dell PC 24-7.
Good night.
Like this Dimension desktop with the power and performance of an Intel Pentium 4 processor. It's yours for the amazing price of $499 and double your memory for free. Other desktops start at just $399. Get more out of service and support with Dell. Get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
She could really go places with Flonase. Allegra is approved to treat nasal and non-nasal symptoms from just one cause. Zyrtec and Claritin are approved to treat nasal and non-nasal symptoms from just two causes. Only Flonase is approved to treat nasal symptoms from all three: outdoor allergies, indoor allergies, and environmental troublemakers. For best results, use daily. Side effects are generally mild and may include headache, nosebleed, and sore throat.
I came back. I needed a refill.
Talk to your doctor about Flonase.
Chris Davis with you in the studio. Let's get you up to date on the current voting in our big man on campus poll. Larry O'Bannon, with his performance against Marquette, 30 points, 6 for 6 and 3, is leading the way. Got to fire up those computers on the Palouse. Get some support for Wazoo's Thomas Kalati.
And Matt Harrius, he might be able to rally late. Stanford had some interesting
Start
results that we saw in Maui.
Another West Coast bias issue.
You saw that sign. They want Chevy to ride them to the Final Four. They've been to the Sweet 16 each of the last three seasons, but of the five teams that have been in each of the last three Sweet 16s, Pittsburgh's the only one that hasn't made it to the Final Four.
They got the size to do it this year with Taft coming along and Gray as a backup. Too easy when you're trying to come back.
McGrath with Gomes back in there now. Just did get that little breather before the TV timeout. Trying to take advantage of Troutman's absence with three fouls. Cote, Hankey, and Birch.
Providence with a little flex look. Very well defended by Pittsburgh.
10 to shoot. Under 11 minutes to go now.
Pretty luck.
Boy, that was nice. Cote to Gomes.
They make you run your offense too, Pitt. They don't give you anything easy.
Tuukka Cote, senior, will likely head back to Finland and try to play professionally in Europe when he's done this year at Providence. 23 years old. Spent a year in the Finnish Army before he came to Providence. He was actually in the Army when Tim Welsh went over to Finland to recruit him. Taft fouled. And tomorrow night it's Super Tuesday presented by Toyota. One of the appealing matchups of the season to date. Number one Illinois facing one of its biggest challenges of the season at East Lansing to take on Michigan State. Florida and Mississippi State, the SEC offering right here on ESPN2 at 8 Eastern Time.
You know, that matchup, I think Augustine and Davis, you mentioned the ankle with Davis and back in good health. Augustine's been playing very good basketball as well.
Well, he really has.
Gomes fouls Taft, who will have a chance for three.
Good teamwork. I mean, they've got a good spirit about them now as we check out the halves.
BC continues undefeated. You can see Utah putting its 12-game winning streak on the line against arch rival BYU at midnight tonight.
People think Bogut's up in the top one or two now.
Oh, in terms of the draft. Andrew Bogut is a player. Great hands, an outstanding rebounder. And I'll tell you, Ray Giacoletti has done a really good job with that team. And I have it on solid information. He is going to break out a suit tonight.
Uh-oh.
That will be quite memorable for the Utah fans.
What was the suit last year?
Last year at Eastern Washington, yeah. He had a cream-colored suit that was quite forgettable. This year, I am told that he is breaking out a red suit tonight.
The leader of the band. Now that's inside stuff.
Ramon the floater.
Well, they are just out scrapping him.
Yep, and that's really been the case all night long.
Is there any question who's going to get that
ball?
No. Taft just keeps it alive.
That's a backcourt.
McGrath should have let it go.
It would have
been a backcourt, but McGrath dove for it and touched it. That took off the backcourt.
Leon Lett.
The crowd loves this. And this is what they've become accustomed to over the years of Ben Holland and now Jamie Dixon.
And they put you in the grinder now. Run their offense. Use a lot of clock. Down to five. Oh, that's a carry.
Taft with the dunk off the miss by Krauser. And you're right, Bill. You can't execute that move unless you carry the ball.
Absolutely not, but they use a lot of time. Timmy needs the timeout. They're playing a very good team that right now is on the top of their game, Jay.
Yeah, you have to think that win at Connecticut last Saturday night, coming from 17 down, has really turned their whole season around. They were just kind of making their way in so-so fashion through the season.
Nobody on here to check out as Taft roams. Send it in, big fella.
You know, Sean, you mentioned the performance that they had against UConn. It reminded me of Kentucky a few years ago in the second half against Vanderbilt, where they found a defense that carried them through the rest of the season. And I really think that Pittsburgh found their defense in the second half against UConn, and they've carried it forward in just great fashion. They're starting to really beat people up defensively now.
No need for a comeback tonight. They've never trailed in the game. 17 points, 11 rebounds for Taft. That's his third double-double of the season. 9 minutes to go, the largest lead of the night now. And Ramon Steele from Brewington.
Nice give. Oh, that's great basketball.
And look at the great effort by Benjamin to go after that rebound, even though he didn't get it. Hill wound up with it and was fouled.
Now, you think of the solid offense, solid defense, but the desire and effort is incredible as well by Pittsburgh.
So Herbert Hill goes to shoot a 1-1. That's the seventh team foul against Pittsburgh. The next will be the seventh against Providence. The line drive wouldn't go. Krauser had the rebound. Gomes thought he was fouled as he went for the rebound.
Taft runs effortlessly as well. This three-guard look is very tough. Play small or big. He likes to come back to that left shoulder. Nice step through. How about that?
And a tip in by Taft, who stayed with the play.
Cannot leave your feet when you've pushed him that far out. Make him shoot over. He is not a good shooter.
Nice cut, and then the terrific look. Nice reception there by Brewington, who has really had a tough night.
That's his first bucket. First points for Dwight Brewington, the sophomore from Lynn, Massachusetts. And a foul on Ramon.
Well, you work on these moves all your life as a big guy, Jay.
Yeah, but you have got to stay solid and behind him there when you've pushed him that far out. You see Hill goes for this little fake, the up and under move, and allows him to get to the basket.
Big hand for Taft as he goes out. Ramon also went out with four fouls, and McCarroll will take a seat. Troutman comes back in with Gray and Kendall. And Brewington is at the line. 64% free throw shooter. Big night for Taft, as was the case when they routed Providence in the Rhode Island Capitol last year.
Well, this is the best he's played this year. He had 20 against Georgetown in a solid effort, but he had to work for everything tonight and outworked his counterpart from Providence on just about every play.
Yeah, that's a good hustle for
one of the few times tonight where they have won the 50-50 ball, if you will. Brewington got there, saw the hearing aids. For those who do not know his story, he has about 70% hearing loss. Tim Lowe says his teammates have learned to make sure that Brewington is aware of what they're doing at all times, because he frequently cannot hear, obviously, the instructions from the bench. Brewington.
On cue, huh? Nice little kick for the post. And they've got him a tutor, and he gets his notes. And they feel he's really blossomed in basketball, too. He feels so good, outgoing. He came over and said hello to the three of us today.
Had trouble academically last year without the tutoring. And it affected basketball and really all of his social life. This year with the tutor helping him, he's a two-way student the last semester. And it's helped his basketball, too. Back to Pittsburgh in a moment.
The Chicken Enchilada Grilled Stuffed Burrito. Slow simmered enchilada sauce, all white meat chicken and melted cheese. Smothered on the inside, wrapped up, then grilled to go. For enchilada taste that's delicious inside and out, think outside the bun.
The Hyundai Sonata was named highest-ranked entry midsize car in initial quality by J.D. Power & Associates. So how do we make it even better? First, you add a $750 special value package at no additional cost. Then you offer $1,500 cash back. And don't forget, every Sonata is backed by America's best warranty, 10 years, 100,000 miles. The Hyundai Sonata GLS special value model is now available at your Hyundai dealer. Starting at $17,499. Don't miss your opportunity to get the special value package and $1,500 cash back.
Mother Nature can be harsh on your car. That's why there's Rain-X. From windshield treatment to wax, everything you need to weatherproof your vehicle.
The Chicken Enchilada Grilled Stuffed Burrito. Slow simmered enchilada sauce, all white meat chicken and melted cheese. Smothered on the inside, wrapped up, then grilled to go. For enchilada taste that's delicious inside and out, think outside the bun.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here. And in part by Hyundai. When your car comes with America's best warranty, you win. Hyundai.
Pittsburgh with their back-to-back impressive wins over nationally ranked foes moved up to 15th in the ESPN rankings released tonight. Boston College at 18-0 is fifth. Why is Kentucky ahead of them?
Tradition, probably, but I agree. Boston College, unbeaten, probably should be ahead of Kentucky. Mm-hmm. You can't imagine why they wouldn't be in the top four. They've done everything that's asked of them.
Highest ranking in the history of the school, and that is a school that has a nice basketball tradition.
So Kentucky Saturday, they are deep. I don't know if they're where Tubby wants them to be or where they can be. That's all that counts anyhow.
I'll tell you, they get out and guard you on every possession, don't they?
Aaron Gray makes the first free throw out of the timeout. You saw the top three, and all three of them will be featured on ESPN this week. Illinois tomorrow in that big game at Michigan State. North Carolina against NC State, and Kansas at Nebraska. Of course, the Cornhuskers had a shot to beat Kansas at Allen Fieldhouse the last time they played. They'll play in Lincoln this Saturday.
Nice play by Kendall. Switch to the deny side. Got to score, guys. They've got to do it quickly. Get some quick hitters.
Down by 17 with 7 and change to go. Holmes has had far fewer touches in this half. Now he has it. Working on Kendall, who is a 6'9 soccer goalie in Canada, and a tip-in by Dwight Brewington.
Very active, good rebounder for a guard.
Here's Krauser trying to get ahead of the field, and he does.
How about the pass by Gray? Big fella committing. And Jamie wanted a timeout there. That's interesting.
He was telling us the story about how he found Kendall in Canada. He was actually going up to Canada to scout Denham Brown, who's a native of Toronto and was, of course, playing for the Yukon Huskies. And while he was watching the national tournament up in Canada, they noticed Kendall. And the next thing you know, he's a Panther.
A musician or musical background, right?
Is that a
composer? An anthropology major.
9 points for Gray.
See, there, Bill, he got caught on the wrong side, going for the steal off that right shoulder, and that just gives Gomes the opportunity to seal him off at an angle inside.
Well, that's what's great about the tape, too. He got, as you mentioned, on that side. That's what's wonderful. You got to know exactly where the ball is, how to position yourself, and don't sell out. I think you sell out gambling for the ball.
16-point lead, 6:09 to go. And the Friars trying to bring the pressure. Krauser, showtime, but Gray's not that tall. He's only the second seven-footer in the history of the program. Mark Blount the other, but
he comes back and gets it.
Came back and stripped it away from Gomes. Somebody needed to tell Gomes that Krauser was sneaking up behind him.
I don't think that's the play for Gray yet, even though he's transformed that body considerably.
5:40 to go. Panthers have won the last three from the Friars and four of the last five. Troutman fouled by Birch.
And you notice Gray in the middle there just waiting. And they double, they get position.
Troutman just throws that big body into you, creates that contact. And he is either going to score or get fouled once he gets the ball into the post.
Charlie Birch is fouled out. He did not score in the game. The freshman from Dorchester, Massachusetts, out of Tabor Academy.
Here's Troutman just getting a little bit of an angle. Birch right behind him, and he just goes right into him and forces that contact and forces the foul.
What do you think about football down the road? Played a little in high school.
For Troutman?
I mean, if he doesn't make the NBA or play in Europe, I mean, it's happening frequently, or on occasion, I should say.
I see him being a tight end.
Boy, what a body, though. I mean, the other thing is it's a different mentality, right? The linebacker mentality of football.
What do you think are his NBA chances?
I think he can play in the league. I do, but it's going to take a while. I think he's going to develop that 15-footer. Mm-hmm.
But he's a 6'7 power forward, and not the type of power forward that's going to rise up over you. I mean, he's got a chance. He can play in the league, but he's gonna have to find the right situation.
Corliss Williamson, not quite as good offensively, but that's the kind of body that he has.
Makes the first.
And there have been a couple of basketball players. Antonio Gates comes to mind as the first, but Tony Gonzalez as well played basketball at Cal.
Pete Gent, you remember that name?
James McDonald way back when at USC.
Sam Clancy, right here. Former Pitt grade.
Why do I feel like I'm on a game show with you two all of a sudden?
He was with the Browns. Great basketball player at Pitt.
18-point lead for Pittsburgh. Gomes threw up the very difficult shot and got bailed out on the foul. I mean, the chances of actually making that shot were pretty slim, but Aaron Gray got called for the person.
I like his attitude tonight, though, Gomes. He is trying to be involved. Wouldn't you agree, Jay?
Yeah.
This is the kind of performance, wanting it, asking, and they're providing it.
Chris Taft back in for Gray. He goes to the bench with four fouls. Back-to-back nice performances by Gray. He gave him 6 points and four rebounds against Syracuse on Saturday. They're right back into the thick of this race now. That gave Syracuse their first loss. BC undefeated in the league, and Pittsburgh's alone in third place with two losses. Great effort by Kendall to swipe it ahead. Krauser.
So he threw the arm out, too.
He sure did.
Yeah, he got away with it. Troutman got it to the little guy, though.
That would have been an automatic offensive foul in the NBA.
And they read it.
Well, handicap the race. the rest of the way. BC, I think, has proven they're for real, but are they for real enough to stay right at the top all year long?
I've got to get my racing form to handicap, but I think BC is the most underrated basketball team with the most underrated coach in the country. Just, you know, a team that nobody really believes in. And you had said to me, close games down the stretch, they win them. Last minute.
They believe they're going to win. They had a couple of shaky games, close games against non-conference bowls like Yale and Boston University and Holy Cross and Kent State. Kent State has a very good program. But they survived those early, and it really seemed to propel them forward with great confidence.
Boy, they're mentally tough, aren't they? Especially Dudley.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to find a tougher kid mentally than Jared Dudley. I think he's turned into a really good player. I think he was labeled as a guy who was kind of a garbage man, scrappy, but he can really play.
Look at the numbers here. He's the edge guy, I think. Much like Kenyon Martin was at Cincinnati. Maybe not that level of performer, but quick timeout here by Timmy. He saw the numbers. The psyche has been punished.
Yeah, this is just to salvage your team mentally and emotionally now. They're about to be 0-7 in the league for the first time ever. For a team that projected in the middle of the pack and had a lot of success last year, you don't want the season to get away because up till now, the attitude has been very good. College basketball action continues on ESPN Wednesday night. A doubleheader of action at 7 Eastern. Jason Maxiel and the Cincinnati Bearcats look to avenge their home loss to host Francisco Garcia and the Louisville Cardinals. And then at 9 Eastern time, ACC Wednesday presented by Staples. Battle two Goliaths as Duke takes on Wake Forest. One of the best guards in the country, J.J. Redick, Chris Paul, Justin Gray. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. Speaking of Louisville and Cincinnati, they will join the Big East next year as the conferences continue to realign. It'll become a 16-team league. Louisville and Cincinnati are in the top 25 right now.
By the way, Villanova has started to play very good basketball. And you mentioned handicapping. If Syracuse, those four sophomores, step in and keep improving, and Edwin keeps blending in, they're going to be reckoned with come tournament time.
How about with the writer in the Pittsburgh paper called the Syracuse duo of Warwick and McNamara today? Old rubber arms and the next Steve Kerr. Which I thought was a characterization.
A couple of referees do anything to get into a game for free, huh?
Look, who's talking on that one, Jay?
What did you teach me when I was younger? If it's free, it's for me.
That's right. The old adage of the media, if it's free, I'll take three.
Nice pass.
Sure was.
And Hill making sure that somebody isn't going to reject that one. Gomes to Herbert Hill. And I think Tim Welsh delivered a message in that timeout because they came out with some focus and intensity despite the score.
They got a timeout from Jamie Dixon, but I think you're right on the money, too. A little attitude about that defensive trip.
Jamie Dixon with a timeout, so we have a moment to look back on this date in college basketball history.
The passion, the pride, the emotion that takes place in a matchup like this is so unique and special.
What a party! Are you kidding?
You talk about versatility.
Not maybe what a pass.
I mean, are you kidding me?
What a pass by Duhon and what a catch by Dunleavy.
That was a Duke 87-58 victory 3 years ago tonight. One of the highlights for them in that historic rivalry with their arch rivals that dates back to 1920.
It's one of the great, if not the greatest. I think you'd agree, having competed in so many of them, both in the AC tournament and the two in the regular season.
Rivalry week next week on the Family of Networks, starting on Monday. We'll be up at the Cuse.
The Cuse! I saw that little wink by Duhon here. Dang. Doing okay in Chicago right now.
And Duhon has the ability to run a team. He can guard.
Benjamin. And here's Brewington. With Pittsburgh leading by 19, nearing 3.5 minutes to go. The Panthers on their way to 15-3 overall and 5-2 in the Big East. Gomes fouled on the handoff by Troutman. That is the fourth on Troutman. After the break, we'll check into the studio with a potential shot of the year candidate right after this.
The Hyundai Sonata was named highest-ranked entry midsize car in initial quality by J.D. Power & Associates. So how do we make it even better? First, you add a $750 special value package at no additional cost. Then you offer $1,500 cash back. And don't forget, every Sonata is backed by America's best warranty, 10 years, 100,000 miles. The Hyundai Sonata GLS special value model is now available at your Hyundai dealer. Starting at $17,499. Don't miss your opportunity to get the special value package and $1,500 cash back.
At BASF, we don't make the mattress, we make it softer. We don't make the boots, we make them drier. We don't make the house, we make it livelier. We don't make the snowboard, we make it stronger. At BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy, we make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF.
Brontosaurus combo with fries.
Since the beginning of time.
Your mutton combo with fries, sire.
Very good.
Combos included fries.
Your deluxe combo with fries.
Hey!
The Wendy's has changed everything. Introducing combo choices. Choose fries, chili, baked potato, side, or Caesar side salad at no extra cost. Dave Thomas said you deserve a choice.
Your classic single combo with the side salad.
Thanks.
And now you get it, only at Wendy's. Our pickup window is open till midnight or later.
You won't see a better highlight than this. Division three, Randolph-Macon and Guilford. 0.6 seconds to go. Randolph-Macon just have to hit the rim and the game's over. They missed the free throw. Jordan Snipes, bottom from 90 feet. Guilford's Jordan Snipes wearing World B Free's old number hits one from World B Free range, and somewhere ML Carr is waving a towel. Guilford by two.
It's almost like he knew it was going in. It was about halfway there. You see him start running toward the sideline.
Unbelievable. And then the low ceiling, too. He couldn't get it that high in the air. Incredible. Bad defense.
Horrendous
coaching.
You got
to challenge. You got to challenge that shot.
How can you give that guy a wide open shot like that? Gomes makes the free throw. He's up to 24. To lead all scorers. Taft and Krauser with 19 apiece for Pittsburgh and 14 for Chevy Troutman. Taft the rebound. We're in amongst the people here, and the season ticket holders are all raving about Taft, saying this is his best performance of the year.
I think it all starts with Troutman, Sean.
Yep.
I think he has taught these guys how to compete, how to get open.
He sets the bar with his level of toughness.
Look at this. Sends it in. Zavarian. Well, they've had a few good players from there, the Mullen brothers.
Chris and Terrence. Roger McCready.
Caught the screen
Boston
from Providence,
College.
Right?
Caught the screen at Providence. Panthers ball with 2:49 to go. Taft has tied his season high now with 21 points. He hasn't seemed all that talkative tonight. There was a major article about him earlier this year in ESPN, the magazine, where he talked about he's one of the all-time woofers.
He did the shirt routine, I saw. You know, everybody knows he's on Pittsburgh. I couldn't picture Jay being a woofer, though. I think he just punished you with his talent.
And at 0-7.
Too busy gasping for breath.
0-7 in the league now for Providence, Bill, a place you were many times during your coaching career. What kind of advice would you give Timmy?
Just keep working hard. I mean, what else? I think Gomes is a good example. If he plays like that, other people. I think it's such a tough road game to begin with against a team, as noted, that has found themselves. And just keep trucking. I mean, he's done a great job with their attitude. And I also think going home against Virginia, that becomes what is an incredibly tough game. And they need the fan support, too.
Yeah.
When you come into this building here, you've got everybody, they're behind their team totally, and I think that's what they have to do up there in that great city.
Parmer, a three. John DeGroats in for Pittsburgh, number zero there with the ball. And I don't know what Tony Green is calling a held ball, apparently. But the problem sometimes in Providence, Bill, we've all been there a lot over the years, because Providence College is really the only game in town, it has a pro mentality sometimes with the fans, and they can be a little tough on the players and coaches. And if anything, this is a time that they could use some support.
Well, when they have a great history that they have, a lot of people are accustomed to success. And coming into this year with Gomes back, I think everybody felt that they would be able to accomplish that. But once they got into the league, I saw them at Memphis early, a great win before Christmas, that they were ready to go. And I think, in a way, Ryan Gomes has to set the tone, which I think he did tonight. So hopefully it'll get going. Other guys can step in, like a Brewington, come up with a solid play he has had of late.
According to the RPI, Providence has played one of the toughest schedules in the country. Taft to dunk. So no matter how you slice it, 0-7, the league is a disappointment, even with all the close calls. As Bill Parcells said memorably, you are what you are, and what they are is 0-7 in a league that's very tough to get off the mat.
Yeah, there's nobody with a helping hand. I'm not coaching anymore.
There are really very few layup games in the league. Games that you know if you play well, you'll win. And the Big East, you can play well and lose. And that's the sign of a tough league.
I think Tim would be the first to admit they did not play well. They didn't exert the kind of aggressive play needed to compete against Pitt.
Pittsburgh. Two record in the league after this one. Travels just down the road, about an hour and change, to West Virginia. St. John's and Notre Dame here. Then at Syracuse, a big Monday game we'll have for you. And at Villanova against Jay Wright's resurgent bunch.
Last three games on that list. All really tough games for Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh has always had a tough time with Notre Dame.
Mm-hmm. Of course, you know, Bill Hillgrove, who does the radio, he said he would be at the Super Bowl if they had done well against your Patriots.
P-A-T-S, Pats, 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 baby.
Because he and Dick Grote, a long time play-by-play. There's Dick.
What a lousy athlete he was, huh? Major league baseball player, a basketball All-American at Duke.
That's one of the great players at Duke.
As compared to some others in the building, is that what
that we've gotten to know.
And one of the most humble as well. Oh, if you ask Dick Grote, the 1960 National League MVP with the Pittsburgh Pirates, will say, oh, I wasn't any good at baseball, but I was pretty good at basketball.
Ed Red Auerbach, John Feinstein wrote that book. Let me tell you his story. He talked about Dick Grote as a basketball player. Red thought he could have been a great NBA performer. I think he did it for 2 years.
Just a prince of a human being as well. Parmer bangs one in. That's one of the most entertaining duos in the country, providing radio anywhere. Bill Hillgrove and Dick Grote, the people in this part of the country are very lucky to listen to them.
What I like the most about both of them, they know where to go after the game.
And that's it. Pittsburgh continues rolling. A huge night for Taft. A career-high 25 and 15 rebounds to boot. They go to 15-3 overall, 5-2 in the Big East. Providence 0-7 in conference, 9-11 overall. First time ever that they've been 0-7 in the league. Once again, our final score from Pittsburgh, the Panthers 86, the Providence College Friars 66. Coming up next is Tilt, presented by Toyota. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. Good night, everybody, from Pittsburgh.
Close cap.